deflected. Hearts have the lead over Celtic.
Here come the cup finalists. Oh, and here come the champions.
From Russia with Lenin. Celtic back home after their glorious win over Spartak Moscow. From the Champions League to the Scottish Premier League. If they can overcome travel fatigue, they can go top today. A point would move them above leaders Hibernian on goal difference. A win and they'd go 2 points clear. Hearts performed well in the Europa League and came within minutes of beating Liverpool at Anfield. Domestically, it's been a slow start with just 2 wins from 9 in the SPL. Hearts took the Scottish Cup home to Edinburgh in May. Today will be a big test of nerve. We're in Glasgow, at the home of the champions. It's in crystal clear high definition on Sky Sports 4HD, and mobile device users can see it using SkyGo. Well, in the absence of the Old Firm game, Celtic against Hearts is the most anticipated fixture in the Clydesdale Bank Premier League season. With me today, Neil McCann, who was in the last Hearts team to win an SPL game here, and fresh from scoring the winner from Middlesbrough yesterday, it's the former Celtic striker Scott McDonald, doing a pretty decent impersonation of Archie Gemmell there. Scott, great to have you with us, especially after that. Did you fly up from Watford without the aid of an aeroplane?
Not quite. It's nice to be here and looking forward to the game today.
Will the Celtic players be flying after that result in Moscow?
You would like to think so. Obviously the euphoria of winning on Tuesday night, which was an absolutely tremendous result. You would think that they might have a come down tonight, today. But obviously it's Neil Lennon's job to get the boys up for it. And I'm really surprised that there hasn't been more changes today to freshen up the team. There's only one change, I think. So. Be interesting to see how they go today.
You mentioned a come down there. What do you mean by that? You scored the winner famously 5 years ago this week against AC Milan, the then European champions. Did you suffer a come down after that?
Yeah, I think it's always hard on the back of Champions League games, and they've given their all as well. You know, they've run that extra, you know, kilometre, you know, during the week and played top quality side. So it's difficult. And when I play for Celtic and, you know, we played against teams after a Champions League game, it was always difficult, and we come off the back of it and, you know, struggled. I think we won a couple and we lost a couple. I think what helps today is that Celtic's playing at home. If they were playing away from home, I think it would be a lot more difficult, and I still fully expect them to get 3 points today.
Neil, will your old team be coming here and hoping that they can take advantage of Celtic being leggy?
I think anyone coming outside Celtic in the SPL, be hoping that that's going to be the case. Celtic will be focused on the Champions League. Hearts will be no different. Coming to Celtic Park's always difficult, but these games are always brilliant occasions to play on. Celtic v Hearts is always one that you look forward to in the calendar. And I think that's a big thing that Neil Lennon has to get into his team. I don't think they started the season well. I think they were possibly still thinking that, you know, they're going to be eventual champions again. And that's something that must be addressed, because on the balance of things, you always get a good competition in Scotland, and then it's always a quality it takes over, and that's what allows Celtic to win the championship last season. And Hearts have to start the game well. They must limit Celtic to chances, and if they can nick one today, I'm sure John McGinn will be absolutely delighted.
Neil Lennon has warned his players about flatness after a Champions League game. No Scott Brown today. He's not even on the bench today. Will that be an issue, given that that is exactly the kind of thing that he tends to prevent his energy, stop Celtic being flat?
I just really like Scott Brown when he's in the team. I think Celtic are a weaker side when he's out of it. And it's maybe not Scott's, you know, threading a pass or guile. It's his energy he brings, his power, his determination. And alongside Wanyama, I think those two have been absolutely dynamic, and none more so. Sensational result.
Yeah.
That's Samaras, you know, there from your time at Celtic. Wanyama has come into the team, and Neil touched on him there. Would you fancy being smashed by him in midfield?
No, not at all. He's really impressed me since he's come to the club. He's just grew in stature game by game. And obviously he's been getting a lot of plaudits, and I think he's been linked with, I think, Manchester United of late. Yeah. So, you know, it just shows how well he's come on, and, you know, he's going to be big for them again today. Obviously at times I think he can be a bit rash with his challenges, but apart from that, he's an exceptional footballer.
He's only 21, but he's built like someone who's much older. Callum Patterson of Hearts is 17, turns 18 next Saturday. He scored a couple of goals. It's his 12th consecutive start How impressed have you been with this young fella since he started, made his debut at the start of the season?
Well, I don't think a lot of people knew an awful lot about Callum Patterson. What I do know about the kid is he came to Hearts as a left winger. Now, we've seen him breaking onto the scene as a right back. He's then went to play right midfield. He went up in Anfield as a striker position, which is where he'll probably play today. And I just feel that for one so young, he's got so much promise, and I just hope Hearts harness that in the right direction. But it's a lot of pressure on a young man's shoulders, but he seems to be handling it well.
Yeah, we'll keep an eye on him this afternoon. We kick off at 12:45. Before that, let's find out what the two managers are thinking about the big game.
Neil, do you expect to pick up from where you left off in Moscow?
Well, you're always hoping to, but these are very difficult games, especially after the euphoria of Tuesday. We've given the players a couple of days to get away from it all and sort of refocus their energies again. So I am hoping that we can replicate the level of performance we've had in the previous two games. But allied to that, I've got a good squad now. You know, the bench is strong today, so I've seen any sign of fatigue at all, and we've got good players to come on and hopefully change things.
What do you expect from Hearts?
I expect them to be compact. I expect them to... They've got good pace in wide areas with Driver, Novakovic, and obviously young Patterson, who has impressed me whenever I've seen him. So, you know, their counter-attacking abilities will be there. Allied to that, they've got, you know, good experience in the back four. Strong in midfield, so this is a good game for us really to come back after Tuesday. You know, it could be a wet blanket some of these games, but Celtic Hearts are normally, you know, good affairs.
John, what's the approach today?
Well, very much. You know, we're in a difficult game today. Obviously, you're coming to the reigning champions and many people's favourites for the title this year. So we're going to make it difficult. Try and make it as difficult as possible for Celtic, cause them a threat, which we plan to do in the games we played against Liverpool. So we come here today, we're looking to play, we're looking to cause Celtic problems, but not being too open and giving them, you know, opportunities to go ahead in the game. So very much a balanced approach with regards to, we don't just want to come here and sit back, of course we don't, but we need to make sure that we're in the game and causing Celtic problems.
Well, teams are in the tunnels. Let's waste no time and join our commentators, Andy Walker and Ian Crocker.
Thank you, David. Well, the Celtics' season is definitely gathering pace. They've won their last four games, and that first ever away win in the Champions League has given them renewed confidence for the challenges that lie ahead. And the immediate challenge is Hearts. They've had a largely indifferent start to the season, just two wins so far in the SPL. Celtic are wearing their 125th anniversary kit today. The last time they didn't wear the hoops for a competitive match here, well, some great minds within Celtic reckoned it was way back in 1983 against Sporting Lisbon. Celtic were shunted off the top of the table by Hibs yesterday, but they could soon return to the summit. I wonder if any Hibs fans might cheer on Hearts. Maybe not. There's a fair bit of fiery history between these two teams. Charlie Mulgrew wearing the captain's armband in the absence of Scott Brown, Marius Zaniukas leading out Hearts. These two teams won the big prizes in Scotland last season. Celtic SPL champions, Hearts Scottish Cup winners. Skipper Scott Brown's ongoing hip problem rules him out. James Forrest returns to the starting lineup. Adam Matthews is still absent with an ankle injury. A milestone for Gary Hooper today, his 100th game for Celtic. Just the 60 goals so far for Hooper of the Hoops. No England call-up for him yet, but Fraser Forster is in Roy Hodgson's latest squad. Hearts make one change in the side that lost to Kilmarnock. Andy Webster is fit enough to return. So Darren Barr reverts to midfield and Scott Robinson drops to the bench. Ryan Stevenson is a jambo again after a brief spell at Ipswich. Callum Patterson started the season at right back but has been converted to a striker. He's only 17, but not for much longer. He'll come of age next Saturday. Tunisian striker Lassad has recovered from a calf injury to make the Celtic bench. The heart subs include John Sutton, whose brother Chris spent five rather good years at Celtic.